情 PTS， 英讯 News， 阿沈卢佩。DBP legislator 高嘉瑜 was physically assaulted by her boyfriend 林炳书 after Gao reported it to the police. She held a press conference accompanied by her lawyer. She said that she has seen the darkest and most terrifying side of human nature. She also said she feels stupid for not knowing people well.
那整个过程，我是不想再去想了，但是。说实话，我人生的第一次遇到这种。
Talking about the process of being assaulted, Gao Jiayu could not say anything for a while. She said that she did not expect to meet such a horrible boyfriend. Gao said her boyfriend has intimate videos and photos of the two together and used them to intimidate her. She felt very scared and could only obey him at first.
他惯用的手法可能就是用这个方式来去胁迫他的女朋友，不管是我或是其他的受害人，其实都有类似这样子的一个经验跟状况。所以第一时间，当然我们可能在这样子的一个威胁跟恐惧之下，其实也只能顺着他的意思，然后尽量的不要去激怒他。
Gao's boyfriend, Mr. Lin, told Gao that this was the first time he assaulted a woman and that he had seen a mental disorder doctor and taken medication. However, Gao only realized that he was a repeat offender after media reports. She then decided to report the crime so there would be no other victims.
我觉得受害者可能不是只有我，但是今天这个事件之后，我希望我是最后一个受害者。
那我们今天呢，也一样要跟时间赛跑，所以呢，我们今天也会再检具相关的重要事证呢，来送往这个新北地检署呢，作为检方日后侦办的一个参考。
Gao said those who have never encountered assault could not know the pain and fear of being treated with violence. She called on all people who suffer from abuse to face it bravely and seek assistance.
Legislator Gao Jiayu's boyfriend Lin Bingshu was arrested on December 1st, and prosecutors confiscated objects, including his phone and flash drives.
那有想要跟议员动粗啊？
没有。
为什么打女人？
没有。是要拍不雅影片。
The man denies committing any crimes when faced with questions from reporters. He is a boyfriend surnamed Lin of Democratic Progressive Party legislator Gao Jiayu, who has been accused of physically assaulting her and restricting her movements. He was arrested by the police on December 1st at a hotel in New Taipei City's Banqiao District.
最主要会采取这个比较紧急的这个状况，紧急的搜索，以及这个具体的动作哈，最主要就是避免哈，因为这个媒体的大幅的报道哈，导致这个证据的湮灭，还有被告逃亡。
On November 30th, Gao, accompanied by her lawyer, filed a report at a local police station. Prosecutors then launched an investigation. They determined Lin was suspected of crimes such as forcible detention and coercion.And there was sufficient evidence. They asked the court to issue a search warrant and arrest warrant on the night of November 30th. Prosecutors say the arrest went smoothly and took less than half an hour. The suspect's phone and flash drives were seized.
就是依照这个告诉人哈，也就是这个被害人的指数哈，认为这些这个随身碟或者手机里面可能会有一些这个私密的这个影像或者照片哈，这个所以这个部分我们暂时就是先予以扣押。
Lin's phone and other possessions are thought to contain intimate images of Gao and other women, so prosecutors targeted them for confiscation. They will be handled confidentially and will not be leaked to anyone.Prosecutors are still trying to determine if there are other victims. The case is being investigated for the crimes of injury, forcible detention, coercion, and offenses against privacy.
National 政治 University has confirmed that Lin Bingshu is enrolled in the doctoral program at the university. If the allegations are proven true, he may be expelled based on the university student code of conduct.
Schools have provisions in their code of conduct for students to respond if undergraduate and postgraduate students who are of age commit any form of violence. The circumstances will determine whether a minor demerit or a major demerit is issued. However, if the victim of the physical violence is a partner also attending the school or an off-campus partner, are there any regulations that the school can use? National Taiwan University and National Taiwan Normal University have both included intimate partner violence in their code of conduct. The latter recently amended the provisions to standardize them.
性侵害、性骚扰跟性霸凌的部分呢，根据情节的轻重呢，来订定奖惩的一些办法。如果说他的这个情节呢，已经达到了本刑三年以上的话，就会予以退学。
NTNU says using school rules and regulations to regulate the personal behavior of adult students is a necessary evil. Although it would prefer to use education and mentoring as responses, any violations of laws need to be dealt with. Some students agree.
刑法之外，我觉得校规是可以跟上的，
因为你还是一个学生，所以还是用校规来去教育你吧。就是你还没有出社会，就没有对你那么的严苛。
NTNU says judicial trials take time, and whether offenders can still continue attending school during this time is a difficult problem. However, if the victim is also a student in the same department or school, it can launch a gender equality investigation. If the persons involved are attending the same classes, they will be separated.
President Tsai Ing-wen officially signed the Stalking and Harassment Prevention Law. It clearly states that the 8 major forms of stalking and harassment will be punishable by 5 years in prison.
恭请总统签署法令。
President Tsai Ing-wen officially signed the Stalking and Harassment Prevention Law, which came into effect and will be implemented in 6 months. The law passed the Legislative Yuan's third review on November 19. The 8 major forms of stalking and harassment, including surveillance, waiting, and trailing, are punishable by up to 5 years in prison. If there is a risk of repeated crimes, preventive detention can be carried out.President Tsai also mentioned now is the 25th anniversary of Peng Wanrun's incident. She emphasized that this is an important step to the implementation to prevent and treat gender-based violence.
有了这一部专法，未来对于不当的跟踪及骚扰行为，公权力可以提早介入，提早防范危害。在这条路上，我们永远可以做得更多。做得更好，未来我们会持续的努力，让全体的国人的生活更加的安全，更加的安心。
Recently, there have been frequent violent incidents of abuse and assault, including DPP legislator Gao Jiayu. Tsai declared the government's determination to enforce the law and wants the police to complete training and necessary manpower as soon as possible. The DPP Legislative Caucus also held a press conference to fully support Gao.
我们谢谢嘉瑜站出来，也会支持他，也为他一起加油。我们家暴法1998年就通过，2007年就把它扩大适用到同居关系。
The legislator stated that any violence should be condemned. This incident revealed that domestic violence and unauthorized sexual private images can be used as threatening weapons. The draft law proposed by Fan Yun has passed the first review, and she is asking the Ministry of Justice to legislate as soon as possible.
Now bring some other stories from around Taiwan. Kaohsiung's Today Theater is being demolished on November 30th. Strong winds toppled a fence. Luckily, no one was injured. This was the fourth accident this year at the site. The custom duty and excise tax on wheat, beef, cement, and gasoline and diesel were reduced to stabilize prices. However, many believe this action only benefits businesses. To resolve the industrial labor shortage, the Ministry of Labor has announced that unemployed workers who get work in the construction industry can apply for monthly allowance.The U.S. Army and Lockheed Martin have signed a contract worth $94 million to upgrade the guidance systems of Patriot Advanced Capability 3 missiles. The work will be performed in various countries that use the missiles, including Taiwan. National Defense Minister Qiu Guozhen said that Taiwan hasn't yet been notified, but he believes this upgrade will strengthen defensive capabilities.
Taiwan uses Patriot Advanced Capability 3 missile systems for anti-aircraft defense. It recently asked the U.S. to sell more PAC-3 missiles. Meanwhile, the U.S. Army and Lockheed Martin have signed a contract worth $94 million to upgrade the guidance systems of these missiles. The work will be performed in various countries that use the missiles, including Taiwan.
任何武器装备要升等升级，我们都一个好的，对我们防卫作战有利的嘛。啊，我们会参与，但目前的状况，我们还没有得到任何一个正式通知，要怎么个做法。
There are concerns that PAC-3 missiles serve basically the same purpose as indigenous Skybow 3, yet the military has procured more from the U.S. The Air Force said the two have different purposes. The PAC-3 missile is primarily used against ballistic missiles. Meanwhile, legislators asked National Defense Minister Cho Guo-jin about the recent visit of a U.S. congressional delegation and their promotion of U.S. grants and loans to Taiwan to purchase U.S. weapons. Cho did not deny this occurred, but emphasized that Taiwan needs to be responsible for its own defense, and there is no such thing as a free lunch.
一个方案一过以后，怕交给我，我们就照办。我们中华民国，我们不是美国，所以这个方案只要对我们有利，我们当然要讨论可以接受到什么地步。如果不能，甚至于没有经过我讨论，那我们就这不可能硬吞嘛。
Premier Susan Tsang has used government planes on numerous occasions to promote the government's stance on the year-end referendums. Legislators question his use of administrative resources, and the Kuomintang requested that the Ministry of National Defense make public the president, vice president, and premier's plane usage records. Cho said he has to check whether regulations allow this.
说台海情势40年最紧张，你还要忙再载着苏院长去。
The control UN is inspecting the MND on the issue of extending the compulsory military service period. Cho responded that the ministry doesn't have the authority to make a unilateral decision, and this is a policy formulation issue, and the ministry will gather opinions.
Thank you for watching PTS Issue News. I'm Shen Lu Pei. See you next time.